My name is Joseph Hargan Calvopina, and we are in Dr. Amander Clark's lab at UCLA. I am a PhD student in that lab, currently in my fifth year, and I am interested in understanding the mechanisms behind development to further understand the causes of infertility. During development, there's a lot of changes that go on in these cells that will eventually become sperm cells or egg cells. One of these changes is there's marks that are placed on this DNA. And these marks usually control whether genes turn on or off. And so you can think about it as a very happy, excited puppy on a leash. And so if you let the puppy go, it's just going to run around and cause chaos and confusion. If the puppy's on a leash, you kind of have control over what it's doing. And so what these marks on the DNA do is they control whether genes are going to be expressed or not. And so what I'm trying to see is basically how these marks are controlling the expression of these genes and what happens whether these genes are turned on or off when they are not supposed to, and how that can lead to infertility. The main thing that we use to study this is PCR, so it's called polymerase chain reaction. And it's a way to get a small sample of DNA and basically make a lot of copies of it so that we can actually look at it. And so the way this is done is once all these copies are made, they are run on a gel. DNA has a negative charge, so once a positive charge is applied to one end, negatives attract. So the DNA will slowly travel towards the bottom of the gel. So once we run that DNA, we can actually look at it by using ultraviolet light, and then we can cut out that little piece of DNA and send it in for sequencing to determine whether the marks that we're looking at, these methylation marks, are present on that specific gene or not. One of the things that I really enjoy about working in a lab is that you have companions, you have other graduate students in the lab, you have other postdoctoral scholars in the lab, and you all kind of have the same goal. But at the same time, you all work with each other, and so you're constantly communicating. And a lot of the times it feels that you're like working with friends. And so it's nice to have your friends in a workplace. And it's a very enjoyable place to work. And at the same time, you know, you're trying to make all these hopefully cool discoveries that in the future will lead to something big. What rocks my world about science is that there's just so much mystery about it. We don't know a lot of how things work. And so there's a lot of room for discovery. But I think what fascinates me the most is being able to see it all come together. All the machinery, all the reactions. I mean, our body is composed of, you know, so many different types of cells, yet they all kind of know what to do. They all have their unique responsibilities. Really understanding how everything is put together and how everything works, I think, is very fascinating. And how much we don't know allows for, you know, immense potential for even more discoveries.